Question. Ano tong three forms of coming of Jesus Christ?
Kunan mo siya.
Okay.
Ang three forms of coming of Jesus Christ, yung completeness of man. Man is composed of body, soul, and spirit. Nakikita nyo dyan, di ba?
Oo.
The body, when it changes, yan yung glorified body. The soul, that is yung renewing of your mind daily. Isang proseso to. When your body is changed, in twinkling of an eye, yan, sabi ng Bible. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, in the twinkling of an eye, the body shall be changed. Hindi sinabi, sa katulad tituro ng sa comics, no, na in the twinkling of an eye, nandun ka agad sa taas, no. In the twinkling of an eye, our body shall be changed. Yun ang twinkling of an eye. May pag-akyat, hindi sinabi yan ang twinkling of an eye. How about the soul? Romans 12:1-2. You offer up your bodies as living sacrifice. And tapos, be not conformed to this world, but be renewed. Ano yung renewed? In your mind. Paano nare-renew ang mind? We need daily Bible study. We need daily devotional time. We need to talk to God every day.
Pabasa you pray. Report.
Pabasa report, family. Pag may asawa ka, couple devotional time tawag dyan. Pag mag-isa ka lang, personal devotional time. So you need daily to be washed by His Word. Yeah, may sinabi si Christ dun sa foot washing. You ought to do this to each other. Because after you take a bath, sabi ni Christ, you don't need na kailangan pang magbuong katawan, sabi ni Peter. Buong katawan ko yung hugasan mo. You don't only need to wash your feet. Ibig sabihin, daily, you need renewal. Kasi daily, marami tayong anak, magpaan nila, nakukuha putik, dumi. Ganon din everyday lives, sa trabaho, sa sasakyan, maraming dumi, maraming tayong encounter na that will defile our spirit, our soul. So we need the cleansing word every day. No? So, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word. So the soul eats the word of God, the revelation of the word of God. Let's go to the spirit. So, tutu kami spirit.
Spirit.
Okay.
Which part? Ito.
Actually, magkakambal tong dalawa. Mamaya, explain ko. Ito spirit lang. Ito ang nasa taas.
Nasa taas. Okay.
The spirit in man needs to be connected back to God. But fellowship was cut after the fall. Adam actually was not yet connected. He had the outdwelling presence of God. Pero, after the fall, nawala pa yung outdwelling. So, naranasan pa rin nilang outdwelling, paudot-udot, hindi yun. Let's talk about you becoming one with God. You have a Bible with you? Okay, let me quote. Ay, yung cellphone pala, nandun ang Bible. No? Let me quote verbatim. John 17:21. That they all may be one, as though Father art in me and I in thee. That they all though may be one in us. Becoming one is the original plan of God in creation. God becoming one with His creation. Pinakita yan niya sa mag-asawa. The male and the female shall become one and become one flesh. So, kay Christ, God and Christ became one when the fullness of the Father dwelled in Him. So, let's talk about the believer. The believer can become one with God through Christ. As God has become one with Christ, the Spirit of Christ and of God that became one, ha, is the Holy Spirit that indwells the believer. Mamaya magagadit tayo kung may question. So that's how your spirit gets connected to God through Christ. In the Old Testament, wala pa si Christ, the Spirit of God cannot connect. Temporary gives you outdwelling presence, katulad yung naramdaman ng Pentecostal, pero aalis din yun. Si Elijah, minsan powerful, minsan matatakotin na. Kasi yung spirit, nagde-depart yan eh. Sabi ni David, take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Pwedeng mawala yun eh. So, how about yung becoming one? If it's becoming one, that's the seal of the Holy Ghost, permanent connection. If you are sealed, Ephesians 1, may verse yata rito.
4:13.
Ephesians 1:13. The seal of the Holy Ghost makes instant din ito, katulad ng katawan, instant change. Makes you one with God. And when you become one, Then the Holy Spirit can give you revelation every day. Pag wala kang fellowship, may maramdaman kang grief, hunger. Parang mawawalang kabigyan ng gana sa sine, sa worldly music. No? Mawawala ka ng gana sa libangan. Gusto, inahanap mo fellowship, inahanap mo sharing of the word. So, yan yung tunay na born again. You have the Spirit of God in you, and it brings you to perfection. The Spirit will not leave you, hindi ka patutulugin niya hanggat, kunwari, yung na, ano ka, na-cut off ka sa fellowship, na-cut off ka sa sharing, sa word. No? You feel na hanapin mo na yan. That's your seal. Yeah, that's your assurance for salvation. At hindi ka niya pababayaan na wala kang makain. Kung ikaw ay nag-backslide, yan parang yan pa nga ang may mechanism ng self-destruct mechanism. Papatayin niya ang flesh mo para hindi ka magkasala ng gusto. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, destruction of flesh. Pero yung mga pwede pang ma-isalba, palo ang tawag diyan, chastisement. Okay, tuloy natin after. Pero pwede tayong mag-question answer habang kumain. No? Tuloy natin after meal or during meal.
So stop na.
Pwede mo ikaw, pero pray muna tayo, sige.